I help you with something?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
If you want, Commander. Cerberus has ranks, but it's not the Alliance. No rules about fraternization. Your boat, your call. You want to get friendly with everyone? That's your business.
Relax, Jacob. I'm just interested in what makes you tick.
Anyone else said that, I'd walk away. Most Cerberus people try to play like the elusive man, hiding bullshit behind a smile. But you? I like what I've seen. I'll give you a shot. What do you want to know?
Anyone waiting for you back home?
Only child and no extended family. Never settled down. Didn't seem fair with this job. But you can't miss what you never had.
You seem okay with taking a risk on me. Why?
Soldiers like us know how important trust is to the crew. I'm not used to seeing it on a Cerberus ship. Definitely not from people they put in command. But you focus on more than the job. A threat this big, you can't just throw people at it blind. They need inspiration.
There's a lot riding on this, but we can't give up everything.
Not always a choice we get to make. Good to try, though. I gave it my best back in the Alliance. Got labeled a troublemaker. They were always on the lookout for disruptive types. Cerberus isn't any better. They just put more effort into hiding how much they spy on you.
Let them watch. We're not hiding anything.
Wouldn't matter if we were. It's not like they can reel us in. We're handling this, whether they like it or not. Anyway, I should get back to prep. Nice talking to you, Shepard. Let's do it again sometime.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. How is our newest Turian crew member doing? His injuries looked painful.
He's a soldier. It'll take a lot more than that to keep him down.
There's something about him. I just want to hold him close and whisper, "It will be all right."
I've been through a lot too, Kelly. Some of your therapy sounds perfect right now.
Someday we'll have to set aside some time and really talk. Anything else, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Hadley, you heard about Ferris Fields. Any news on your brother?
He's gone. They're all gone.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Of course. Plague on Omega dealt with. Plenty of time to analyze Collector intelligence. Impressive laboratory setup. Missed working for operations with a budget. AI in particular, very helpful. Best setup I've seen since work with Special Tasks Group.
Is your assistant Daniel settling in all right?
Quite well. Safe and secure. Neighborhood mostly quiet with Plague gone. Left him the security mechs just in case. Can't be too careful. Also tired of mechs. Noisy. Never used them in STG.
It must have been frustrating working on Omega with such a limited facility.
No, loved it. Limited facility presents challenge. Save greatest number of people using limited resources. Security threats, gangs, mercenary groups add additional difficulty. Quite enjoyable. Plague stretched abilities to limit. Couldn't have asked for more. Also, enjoy. Saving people, of course. Helping the helpless, greater good, all that too. Nice. Retirement after SDG work complete.
Tell me more about the Solarian Special Task Group.
Respected organization. Clandestine. Handles difficult assignments with limited oversight. Recon, analysis, occasional wet work. Identify problems, have neutralization options ready should need arise. Model for Council Spectres based on Special Tasks Group. Very similar.
Similar in what way?
Solarians lack numbers. Brute strength, military prowess, have to rely upon stealth, intelligence. Agents trusted, given wide operative freedom. Spectres similar, given goal, told to accomplish. Better funded, of course. Didn't have to buy our own weapons.
You said you were in the Special Tasks Group. What kind of research were you doing?
Not simply research. Several recon missions. Covert, high risk, served under a young captain named Kirihi. Studied Krogan genophage, took water, tissue samples from Krogan colonies.
I worked with an SDG captain named Kirihi. His team helped me destroy Saren's cloning facility on Vermeier.
Heard Kirihi died on Vermeier. Not enough equipment for operation. Still managed to take down facility. Good captain. Dedicated. Bit of a cloaca, though. Loved his speeches. Hold the line. Personally prefer to get job done and go home. Probably military bravado, jargon, chest pounding. No offense.
Why would STG study the genophage?
Krogan rebellion's bloody, dangerous, nearly as bad as Rachni attacks. All species evolve, adapt, mutate. If genophage weakens, need to be prepared.
What was the STG preparing to do?
Military schematics for likely Krogan population growth, political scenarios for attack points. Genophage reduced Krogan numbers. Species aggression unchecked, population explosion would be disastrous. STG helped check Krogan rebellions, needed to be ready to do the same. Simple recon, nothing to worry about.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Bioweapon designed by Salarian science team, deployed by Turians against Krogans to end Krogan rebellions more than 1,000 years ago, affects every cell of Krogan body, commonly and incorrectly considered a sterility plague. Actually adjusts viable fertility rates to compensate for high Krogan birth rate, stabilizes to pre-industrial population growth levels.
Nice talking with you, Morden.
Should get back to work. Need to study. So much data. Here if you need me.
Did you hear? Another colony went missing. Ferris Fields.
Ferris Fields? Didn't Hadley have a brother stationed there?
Yeah, he's taking it pretty hard.
How can I help you, Commander?
Do you have everything you need?
If you happen to find any of those supplies on the list I gave you, it would be much appreciated. Otherwise, I'm doing fine.
I won't take any more of your time.
Back to work.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I'm just finishing an operation report. I'm impressed, Shepard. So far, things have gone exceptionally well.
As Cerberus operations go, this is one of the best I've been a part of.
Maybe that's because this isn't a Cerberus operation.
Not to you, maybe. But I report directly to the Elusive Man, and I'm here because he wants me to be. Cerberus gave you a second chance, Commander. Maybe you should do the same for us.
What did Cerberus do that made you so loyal?
I suppose you deserve to know. Do you remember when I told you how I was genetically altered? Well, that wasn't my choice. My father created me. He's a very influential man and extremely controlling. He didn't want a daughter. He wanted a dynasty. I ran away as soon as I was old and brave enough. I went to Cerberus because I knew they could protect me.
You seem capable of defending yourself. Why did you need Cerberus?
My father invested a great deal in his dynasty. It wasn't a matter of just leaving. I knew he would continue to pursue his investments.
I assume that Cerberus approved of your enhanced abilities?
Of course. Cerberus fully endorses anything that advances the cause of humanity. Genetic alterations included. But unlike my father and his own selfish reasons, Cerberus and the Elusive Man believe in a greater good. They see the bigger picture. And I feel like I have a purpose here.
You talk about yourself like you're just a tool to be used. By your father? By Cerberus?
Maybe. I like to know where I fit in the world. It helps me find meaning in how I was created.
You are who you are, Miranda. You don't need to make excuses for it.
That's easy for you to say. We've both been engineered for greatness, Shepard. The difference is you were great before we rebuilt you. I'm great because of it.
Your spirit and personality are what make you great. It's what makes anyone great.
That's kind of you. I'm not sure I believe you, but thanks for saying it.
Who exactly is your father?
A businessman, but a very wealthy one. It's ironic. My father believed deeply in a human positive agenda. He donated generously to Cerberus before I joined them. That's how I first heard about Cerberus, through my father's connections.
You talk about yourself like you're just a tool to be used. By your father?
Maybe.
By Cerberus?
I like
you are who you are.
The difference is, you were great before we rebuilt you. I'm great because...
You've told me a lot about your father. What happened to your mother?
I never had one. Most of my genetic material is based on my father's tissue. His Y chromosome was altered with an amalgam of desired traits from various sources. How arrogant can you be? The man is completely egomaniacal. Just another reason I had to get away from him.
You talk about yourself like you're just a tool to be you.
That's kind of you. I'm not sure I believe you, but thanks for saying...
Thanks for your time,
Anytime,
Miranda.
Commander.
How may I help you, Commander?
You have everything you need.
I believe so. This medical bay seems very... Only thing missed... I even had a bottle of Ceres Ice Brandy that I was saved... Commander.
Shepard. Need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Sure. Just checking the weapon systems. You can never be too careful. I thought I'd seen every weapon in the galaxy in our fight against Saren. Mercenary work showed me otherwise. And now Cerberus rebuilds the Normandy with a few upgrades to boot. I wish we'd joined up with them sooner.
You sure you're okay working with Cerberus?
I can't exactly doubt your judgment. Not after I got my own squad killed.
What did your Merc squad do? It didn't sound like you were available for hire.
You saw Omega. It was full of thugs kicking the helpless. I formed my team to kick back. We weren't mercenaries. At least nobody was paying us. We made money by taking down slavers, pirates, or gangs that went too far.
It sounds like you were just another gang.
Then I'm saying it wrong. We didn't shake anyone down. No civilian casualties. That was our rule. Every member of my team had lost someone to Omega's gangs. We weren't out to get rich. We were out to make those bastards think twice before murdering someone in the street.
Doesn't sound like you made any friends with the gangs.
I got three separate merc bands to work together to take me down. My manager at CSEC would be impressed. It was simple. We'd hit their shipments, disrupt activities, get under their skin, make them angry. They'd come charging right into our well-prepared kill zone, crossfire and snipers, clean and surgical. They never stood a chance.
How'd you end up fighting mercenaries here on Omega?
After the Normandy was destroyed, most of us went our separate ways. CSEC asked me back, but I turned them down. Omega was filled with criminals nobody else could touch. And there was no red tape to slow me down. It was a perfect fit. People here needed someone to believe in. Someone to stand up to the local thugs.
That explains how you started. How'd you end up with a squad?
Not too different from how you formed your squad to fight Saren, actually. You prove that you get things done, and people join up. Mercs who wanted to atone. Security consultants tired of playing by the rules. I gave them hope. And now they're dead. Shows what I know.
Tell me about your squad.
There were 12 of us, including me. Former military operatives, CSEC agents, the usual. Had a Salarian explosives expert. Pretty sure he'd spent time in the special tasks group. My tech expert was a Batarian, believe it or not. Not the friendliest guy, but he could hack any system ever built.
How did those mercenary gangs take down your team?
It was my own damn fault. One of my people betrayed me. A Turian named Sidonis. He drew me away just before the Mercs attacked my squad. Then he disappeared. Everyone except me is dead because of him. And because I didn't see it coming.
I'm not sure I understand. What happened exactly?
Sidonis asked for my help on a job. When I got to the meeting point, nobody was there. By the time I got back to our hideout, the mercs had killed all but two of my squad. And they didn't last long.
Are you sure it was a betrayal? Maybe they took Sedonis out first.
No. I put out feelers with some old contacts. He booked transport off Omega just before the attack. He also cleared out his private accounts before he left. He sold me out and ran.
Do you know where Sedonis is now?
No. His trail vanishes after he leaves Omega, but I'll keep hunting. I lost my whole team except for Sedonis. One day I'll find him and correct that. Thanks for coming by, Shepard. I've got some things to take care of.
Medigel is a common medicinal salve used by paramedics, EMTs, and military personnel. It combines several useful applications, a local anesthetic, disinfectant, and clotting agent all in one. Once applied, the gel is designed to grip tight to flesh until subjected to a frequency of ultrasound. It is sealable against liquids, most notably blood, as well as contaminants and gases. The gel is a genetically engineered bioplasm created by the CERTA Foundation, a medical technology megacorp based on Earth. Technically, Medigel violates council laws against genetic engineering, but to date, it has proved far too useful to ban. Biotics is the ability of rare individuals to manipulate dark energy and create mass effect fields through the use of electrical impulses from the brain. Intense training and surgically implanted amplifiers are necessary for a biotic to produce mass effect fields powerful enough for practical use. The relative strength of biotic abilities varies greatly among species and with each individual. There are three branches of biotics. Telekinesis uses mass-lowering fields to levitate or impel objects. Mass-raising kinetic fields are used to block or pin objects. Spatial distortion uses rapidly shifting mass fields to shred objects. Most organic species are capable of developing biotic abilities, though there are risks involved. Biotics are the result of an in utero exposure to element zero. This usually causes fatal cancers in the victim, but in rare cases, it coalesces into nodules within the fetus's developing nervous system. When subjected to an electrical current, the rare material dubbed Element Zero, or EZO, emits a dark energy field that raises or lowers the mass of all objects within it. This mass effect is used in countless ways, from generating artificial gravity to manufacturing high-strength construction materials. It is most prominently used to enable faster-than-light space travel. EZO is generated when solid matter, such as a planet, is affected by the energy of a star going supernova. The material is common in the asteroid debris that orbits neutron stars and pulsars. These are dangerous places to mine, requiring extensive use of robotics, telepresence, and shielding to survive the incredible radiation from the dead star. Only a few major corporations can afford the setup costs required to work these primary sources. Humanity discovered refined Element Zero at the Prothean Research Station on Mars, allowing them to create mass effect fields and develop FTL travel. Element Zero can increase or decrease the mass of a volume of space-time when subjected to an electrical current. With a positive current, mass is increased. With a negative current, mass is decreased. The stronger the current, the greater the magnitude of the dark energy mass effect. In space, low mass fields allow FTL travel and inexpensive surface-to-orbit transit. High mass fields create artificial gravity and push space debris away from vessels. In manufacturing, Low-mass fields permit the creation of evenly blended alloys, while high-mass compaction creates dense, sturdy construction materials. The military makes extensive use of mobility-enhancing technologies, with Mass Effect utilizing fighting vehicles standard frontline issue in most military forces. Mass Effect fields are also essential in the creation of kinetic barriers or shields to protect against enemy fire. Mass relays are feats of Prothean engineering advanced far beyond the technology of any living species. They are enormous structures scattered throughout the stars and can create corridors of virtually mass-free space, allowing instantaneous transit between locations separated by years or even centuries of travel using conventional FTL drives. Primary mass relays can propel ships thousands of light years, often from one spiral arm of the galaxy to another. However, they have fixed one-to-one connections. A primary relay connects to one other primary relay and nowhere else. Secondary relays can only propel ships across a few hundred light years. However, they are omnidirectional. A secondary relay can send a ship to any other relay within its limited range. There are many dormant primary relays whose corresponding twins have not yet been located. These are left inactive until their partner is charted, as established civilizations are unwilling to blindly open a passage that might connect them to a hostile species. Omni-tools are handheld devices that combine a computer microframe, sensor analysis pack, and mini-facturing fabricator. Versatile and reliable, an Omni-tool can be used to analyze and adjust the functionality of most standard equipment, including weapons and armor, from a distance. The fabrication module can rapidly assemble small, three-dimensional objects from common, reusable industrial plastics, ceramics, and light alloys. This allows for field repairs and modifications to most standard items, as well as the reuse of salvaged equipment. Omni-tools are standard issue for soldiers and first-in colonists.
I just heard.
collectors hit the Ferris Fields colony. Everyone's gone.
Shit! We're going to make those dirty buggers pay. You're the best, Commander. We just got those FBA couplings installed. Now we only have to calibrate every week instead of every day. We're thinking about celebrating our newfound free time with some Skillion 5 poker. Want to join us?
Come on, Kenneth. The Commander doesn't want to play cards with grease monkeys like us.
Actually, that sounds interesting.
Fantastic. I'll get the cards.
My Skillion 5's a bit rusty. You'll be easy on the rookie, right?
Of course, Commander. It's all friendly.
Yeah, right.
Be gentle on the rookie. I can't believe we fell for that.
It's so worth losing to see you taken down a notch.
Beat me at my own game. You're all right, Shepard. What can we do for you, Commander?
Where did you receive your training?
Both Gabby and I started in the Alliance, serving on the SSV Perugia.
She flew in the first wave at the Battle of the Citadel. We saw Sovereign firsthand.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Hey, don't touch. That rifle's older than you are. I call her Jessie. That's my lucky charm. More men have been killed with that gun than died in the Skillion Blitz. The day I laid her to rest was the saddest day of my life. I'd give up every weapon I own for one more mission with that shitty old rifle. Thinking about past missions. Got a minute. You might learn something. So you knew Archangel from before. Interesting. Knew a lot of men taking jobs to kill the son of a bitch. I never saw the point. You and I wanted the same thing. A whole lot of mercs dead. Hell of a sniper, though. And he kept himself alive with all the mercs in Omega after him. That ain't easy. I was trying to remember how many Cerberus operatives I've killed. Lost track around 50. Guess your elusive man's big on forgiveness. I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard. Oh yeah, that's a model of the Varrican. Turian frigate. Hell of a ship. I led a mission to bring that thing down from the inside with just 5 men and whatever guns we could bring. No chance of success, but we did it. Everyone died but me. So I made out like a bandit. My first impossible mission as an independent contractor. There's been many since, but nothing so goddamn sweet as watching that Turian warship crash planetside. Beauty, isn't it? Pried that off the Krogan warlord, Kazak. Used to run the blood pack out of Omega about 17 years ago. Wasn't even a job. The guy just thought he'd hijack a freighter I was hitchhiking on. Big mistake. I goaded Kazak into one-on-one combat. Took out his legs, grabbed his gun, and killed every blood pack bastard in the room. That was the most beaten Krogan I've ever seen. Kept a helmet to remind me of that pained expression.
plague has been completely eradicated, Shepard. I have also run searches for reports on Archangel. The various mercenary groups appear to believe that he is dead.
Works for me.
Come on, let me in. Ari's expecting me.
Annoyed.
What do you need?
This data pad was on one of the mercs that was after Archangel. They were coming for you next.
Let me see. Interesting. Would someone like to tell me how this information slipped the net?
I'll look into it.
Thanks for the heads up, Shepard. Looks like I'll have to do a little cleaning in my organization.
One scan and we're straight to business? People are usually more concerned about who
I am.
Your
death was... Whatever you need will come out on its own. I'm curious, but...
Tell me how you got set up here.
That's his privilege. I have many friends in it.
So,
you must know... Just don't waste my time. Maybe I'll be here. You do that.
Aria has a job she needs doing. You up for some work?
That depends on what Aria has in mind.
Aria's gotten word that some blood-packed mercs plan to kill an old acquaintance of hers, a Krogan named Patriarch. She'd like you to keep that from happening.
What's the blood-pack's problem with Patriarch?
If you've met Patriarch, you know. He can't keep his damn mouth shut. Some people don't appreciate his stories, especially when he dips into non-fiction.
What's Aria's interest in protecting him?
Patriarch was one of her deadliest enemies back in the old days. Now she keeps what's left of him around as a trophy. As long as he lives, he's a perfect example of what happens when you go up against Aria.
Why come to me? Aria's usual muscle not up to the job?
Because Aria said so. What other reason do you need?
People like Aria don't do things without a damn good reason. I want to hear it.
Fine, but I didn't tell you this. Got me? If it gets out that Aria's protecting Patriarch, well, that can look like a weakness. And some people might want to exploit that. You're not on her payroll, so you helping Patriarch just seems like a random act of kindness.
I'll look into it.
Good. Patriarch's downstairs, likely surrounded by his fans. Get him into hiding until the mercs move on. Come back here when it's done, and you'll get your due.
I'll be back when the job is done.
Good luck.
Some people want you dead. I've been asked to move you to safety.
Well, of course. Aria wouldn't want me hurt. It would make her look bad. But perhaps Aria's reputation is no longer my concern. Perhaps I will stay. See who thinks me important enough to kill.
Here's an idea. Let me handle the assassins for you.
And so your name grows, while I remain an old man who lets others fight his battle.
No. You remain a powerful warlord with forces at his command. Not just Arya's trophy.
Well, you could be. You could be my Krent, fighting for my honor. If you would do this for me, I would be grateful. I might even be a Krogan again. Nothing of the assassins. Do you have news? Or have you changed your mind? Shall I slink back to the safety of Arya's protection?
I should be going.
Human.
You here for Patriarch?
What if we are? You gonna do something about it?
Patriarch sent us. Said to do whatever it take.
You're Patriarch's Krant? I wasn't aware the old man had one.
You should have done your homework.
Patriarch is not to be crossed. Thanks to you, Arya may think of me as more than a trophy. A real advisor, maybe. Or even a threat.
Take care, Patriarch.
For the first time, I like that name. By the way, be careful with Arya. She will approve of what you've done, I think. Not of you altering the balance of Omega. I think it reminds her too much of herself.
You took on the Blood Pack assassins yourself. I wouldn't keep her waiting.
Word has it that Patriarch's Krant took out the men set here to kill him. Funny, I didn't know he had a Krant.
Patriarch has more influence than you thought.
I see. Well, maybe I should watch my back then. It's not what I asked, but you got the job done. You've done a lot for me, Shepard. Let me return the favor. We're sending your coordinates to a cache on an uncharted world. You want it? It's yours.
What's the catch?
No catch. I don't need it, and I don't want it to go to waste. Whatever you find is yours to deal with.
Sounds like you and Patriarch have a history.
Our history is Omega's history. Long, bloody, and always ending in my favor. The details are complicated. When I arrived, Omega was lawless, a land of opportunity. I built alliances and destroyed the fools who wouldn't get in line, which was most of them. But Patriarch, he was something different. A
powerful friend.
I'm surprised you were ever anything but rivals.
We were allies for 100 years. I suppose he decided that was long enough. Wasn't a surprise when he turned. He controlled the muscle. My people contributed more subtle action. Espionage, politics, assassination. Fortunately for me, his men had become accustomed to certain benefits of working with Asari.
Superior intel? Assassination?
That's cute. No, I took advantage of certain skills my people try to downplay. Patriarch's men abandoned him in droves. In the end, we fought face to face on this very spot. The toughest fight of my life. But of course I won.
Patriarch doesn't sound like something an Asari would come up with.
I found it humorous. He wanted power. And we pretended he had it with a word that doesn't exist for my people. I eventually found a certain respect for the title and the man.
So you kept him around as a trophy?
I did. A trophy and an example. Whenever someone thought about taking me on, I pointed them to Patriarch. Dignity is one of the few commodities not available on Omega.
Interesting, but let's move on.
Do you need something else?
We friendly enough to talk about who you were before, Omega?
You're reaching back centuries, Shepard. Long before anything that should matter to you.
So why keep it secret?
No reason, from your perspective. But there are plenty of people out there with long memories. I've had a few careers, a few names. Commando training, mercenary leanings. I've kept what was valuable and dropped the baggage.
I thought you were in charge. Why so scared of your past?
I have nothing to fear on Omega. That doesn't mean I want to broadcast my past to the galaxy. You'd be surprised how long some entities can hold a grudge. This little exercise with Patriarch? A footnote. Not even the first Krogan I've pissed off.
You're important, but also isolated. No other allies out there to back you up?
I lean toward a particular type of work. It tends to encourage professional rivalry. Sometimes you'd rather disappear than be forced to kill someone.
Couldn't have started here with nothing. You must have been someone important.
I've always been important, even if others didn't recognize it. So yes, I had money to start this operation. I also had creditors who thought they were more entitled to it. I let them chase a ghost, or several. It's relatively easy to outlive a Solarian, but not their record keeping.
All right, I'll drop it.
Better luck next time.
Maybe I'll come back later.
Maybe I'll be here.